everybody! Welcome back to Playdate with Art. This month our theme is Terrific Tape. We'll be using tape today. I'll tell you a little bit more about that later. But first, let's visit the Milwaukee Art Museum to see a painting that uses a special kind of tool, kind of similar to the tape that we're going to use today. Let's go!
Hi, I'm here in the Contemporary Galleries at the Milwaukee Art Museum, and next to me is a painting. It's a really big one. It's Untitled, and it's by an artist named Christopher Wool. At first, when you look at it, you might think it sort of looks like a street sign because of the fact that the letters are very standardized, they're very big, and actually it's painted on aluminum, so it's on metal, similar to a street sign. But what does it actually say? F-O-O-L, fool. That's not something I'd usually see on a street sign. What Christopher Wool does with paintings like this is he uses a tool called a stencil. And a stencil is a flat tool that has shapes cut out of it. So you can paint or draw or use other color to make a shape, or in this case, a letter. And you can see where he used a stencil to make the F, the two O's, and the L. And those letters, as I mentioned, do kind of resemble signs that you might see on the street, like a stop sign or a crosswalk sign. But if we look really closely, the letters aren't perfectly sharp all around. If I look at the top of the L, I see a little bump of the black paint. Same with the O on top. There's some little edges where I can see some of the paint that's splashed around, so that we know it was a person who made it and not maybe a machine like a street sign might have made. We can actually see that the artist made it himself with his own stencils. We're gonna use something similar to a stencil to make our own paintings with different designs, and maybe we can try some letters too. Let's go.
Did you like seeing that big painting in the museum? Did you recognize all of the letters? Now we're going to do our own version of a painting. Instead of using a stencil like Christopher Wool used, we're going to use the tape I mentioned earlier. Here I have a couple different types of masking tape. You can see they're different widths. This purple one is a little wider, and the orange one is a little bit skinnier. But the color of the tape doesn't really matter. You'll see. If you don't have masking tape, painter's tape also works, or you might have washi tape, which is a type of craft tape. The trick to the tape that we're using is that it's not too sticky because we're actually going to peel it off of our paper at the end after we finish our painting. So you don't want to use something really sticky like scotch tape or duct tape. Speaking of paper, I have some watercolor paper. That's our heavier paper that's a little bit more thick. So when it gets wet from the paint, it won't get warped. But if you have printer paper, that's fine. Or really any kind of paper you'd like to use. The kind of paint I'm using today is some tempera. I just put a few different colors on a paper plate to use as my palette. And then I have a couple of paint brushes, my cup of water, and a paper towel to keep things dry. So the first thing we're gonna do is lay our tape down. And remember how the painting that we looked at in the gallery, I was talking about the stencil. The stencil has holes where you would put the paint. In the case of that painting, black paint. We're not going to make holes in our paper. We're actually going to cover up lines using our tape. So I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to take a piece of my wider tape and I'm going to rip a nice big piece. And it's actually going to go all the way across my paper from end to end. So I'm going to go like this. And you can see the tape is actually going onto my table here. And that's okay. That'll actually also keep the paper in place. So I can't really wiggle it around. And I'll just stick out another piece, going in another direction, and across this way. I'm kind of doing some angles. Oh, you also want to make sure to smooth down the tape nice and flat. And again, you'll see why later. Maybe I'll switch over to my skinnier tape. And add a piece that's crossing the two pieces I put down before. And your tape doesn't have to go all the way from end to end like I'm doing. You could also do shorter pieces. So maybe I want to put a line across here. You might even want to do letters, kind of similar to the painting that we saw. If you want to do something like, actually, it sort of looks like I did the letter A here. There's the two long lines and the line going across. Maybe I'll put a piece in the middle here and another one to make an X. And then you could also do small pieces of tape too if you want to make kind of little, almost like dots. I'll stick a couple of those. So now what we're going to do is paint on top of the tape. Wherever I can see the white paper, that's where the paint will show up. And the tape is actually going to block the paint from being in the parts where the tape is covering. So if you can imagine the stencil that Christopher Wool used, the holes were where the letters were. In this case, the holes are wherever the tape is not. And that's actually a concept in art called negative space. So that's the space outside of the figure, or in this case, the lines, but we're gonna fill those in. Maybe I'll start with my bigger paintbrush, dry it off a little. And I like this orange paint. And remember, the colors of the tape you're using won't stay. So it actually doesn't matter what color they are or where you put your paint. And you can see I'm painting right over the top. And I'm gonna be really careful, but when you do this, you should probably paint on a tablecloth or some newspaper. I'm just gonna be careful not to get any paint on my table. And actually, even if I do, it's okay, because this is tempera paint, which is washable. How about some blue? I'll fill in another part. So I'm kind of like looking at different parts of the painting, like there's a little white triangle there. And maybe I'll paint part of this blue, but not the whole section. Yeah. Got this triangle here. Dry it off. Get some green on there. If you want to try mixing colors, that's fun to do. If you want to get a little bit messy, you could even do some finger painting here. I'm gonna get my other metallic. I have some gold. Fill in this shape. And just keep going. Remember, this painting isn't really showing us anything, any kind of object or animal or person. It's just filling in colors. And for the little ones, it's nice to just get used to the feel of the paint, holding the brush and really spreading out the color all over in different parts of the paper. Almost filled up all the white part. One thing you want to make sure of is wherever you see the white areas that are right next to the tape, you want to make sure that you're really filling those in. Okay, I've pretty much covered my whole area with paint, and I'll show you so you can see. And you can also see how it's a little bit messy, right? You can see where my paint is kind of smeared all over the tape. Now, the next part is fun because we're going to peel the tape off. You can wait until the paint's all the way dry if you might be worried about your fingers getting messy while you're untaping, but you can do it when it's still wet too. So I'm gonna just start at the end. And here's where having the tape go off the edge of the paper is actually a little nice, because then you have a clean place to grip. So I'll tear off my first piece, and you can already see that nice white line where the orange tape was that I just peeled off. And I'm just going to keep going. All right. Wipe off my fingers. So you can see my paper did rip a little bit, but that's all right. But can you see all the lines, the white lines where my tape was that covered up the paper and blocked the tape from, blocked the paint from appearing? What I can do now, I can let this layer dry, and I can actually put more tape on top of this, and I can add more and layer it so that some of these white areas where the lines are will get some paint on them, and then we can also do some layering on top. So I might just let this dry, and while I do that, waiting to put my next layer of tape, we're gonna head back to the Milwaukee Art Museum to visit with a really cool musical group that I think you're gonna like a lot. And believe it or not, they're doing something similar to what we're doing with the tape, except instead of blocking paint and colors like we're doing, they're gonna block sounds. So I'll let them tell you some more.
Hello, my name is Jennifer Rodriguez, and I'm here with the Microcosm Ensemble. My instrument is the flute, and it can sound like this. Thank you. Or like this.
Hello, my name is Alec Burke with the Microcosm Ensemble. My instrument is the trumpet, and without any alterations whatsoever, this is what it sounds like. Now, just like an electric guitar player, I can change the color and the sound and the effects on my instrument by using something called mutes. So here today, I've got three different mutes. The first one and the most common is the straight mute. This one is made of brass and has a really nasally sound. The next mute that I have for you is more veiled. It's a lot more subtle, it's a lot warmer. This is the cup mute, and you often hear this in musical theaters and jazz. And the last and final mute, one of my favorites, is the harmon mute or the bubble mute because it's shaped like a bubble. Now this one has probably the most diverse set of colors, but without my stem in, it sounds like this. It's really buzzy. But if I put my stem in, I can make really cartoony sound effects like this.
Hi, I'm Edward Forsman. I will be playing the piano today. Sometimes it sounds like this. And other times like this. Today we are going to be performing Trio Sonata by Jim Stevenson. We hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
timing. I'm just peeling off the tape on my new layer of my painting. How did you like the musical performance? Isn't that trio so cool? I love seeing all their instruments together. And it was really cool how the trumpet with the different mutes can make the different sounds. Did you remember how we were thinking about how the tape blocks our colors when we're painting? And then how the mute on the trumpet can block the sound coming out in a similar way. All right, okay, those are my last two pieces. So what I did was I added some new tape on top of the painting that I started before. And then I filled in, not all, just some of the areas. You can see I made some triangular shapes. I added some purple, which I didn't have before. And now you can see where my new lines are. So we're doing some layers. I could even keep adding to here after this dries, more paint on top. You don't want to do it too many times because otherwise at some point, all the white parts will be covered up. So maybe two or three times would work, but even just once is a lot of fun. Thanks for joining me today for Playdate. And thanks for joining me in these videos for the past 2 years. Can you believe it's been that long that we've been meeting together like this? I hope that the next time we see each other, it'll be at the Milwaukee Art Museum. We're gonna take a break this summer, but hopefully we'll be back together this fall. Hope to see you soon. Bye.